Hey guys, Dr. J here again, and wanted to do a follow-up video about our GNSS post-processing, talking about Emlid Studio. So I'm here in Emlid Studio, and I'm going to do a post-processing kinematic workflow, show you guys how to do that. And this is where we're going to take the results from a PPK survey that we performed a couple of weeks ago, and we're going to post-process the results to get final accurate positions for our rover locations. So for those of you guys who don't know what I'm talking about, you can check out my other videos where we talk about static GNSS and RTK GNSS and RTK and PPK GNSS. So check out those videos, and I'll have links to those in the notes below. So here we are in Emlid Studio. Notice that I'm gonna be in the stop and go with Emlid Flow. This is what we're doing when we're doing RTK or PPK with our Emlid GNSS, and I'm using an Emlid Reach RS2 GNSS receiver. And then I'm going to be, I've downloaded my files, so I've got my Rhinox files for my rover, got my Rhinox files for my base station, and I've got my CSV file with the points that I collected while I was doing that kinematic survey. So we're going to choose stop and go. And what I'm going to need to do now is select the Rhinox file for the rover and the base station and the navigation file for the rover. So I'm going to go ahead and click on rover, and I will navigate to my file and upload that to Emlid Studio. All right, got my Rhinox file for the rover. I'm going to click on base station. And then I'm going to also upload the navigation file from the rover. All right, so now I've uploaded my Rhinox file for my rover, my navigation file for my rover, and my base station. And you should notice here that it says Rhinox header position. That means that the position estimate that Emlid Studio is using for the base station is the position estimate that you're getting from the Rhinox header file. Or the header position. So what that means is that when you set up your base station, you're going to take the first 3 minutes or so and kind of average that position. That's going to be the position that's used in Emlid Studio. We've talked in another video about how to do post-processing for your base station using CSRS, and you're going to want to change this to latitude, longitude, height, degrees, minutes, seconds, or decimal degrees if that's what you're using. But I can change this to latitude, longitude, height, and actually put in manually the final corrected version of my base station coordinates. This is the post-process part where I corrected my base station coordinates using CSRS or OPUS, and then I'm going to put that information in here. For right now, I'm just going to leave this as the Rhinox header position, and we'll go ahead and hit process. So it's going to go through, it's going to find all the points where it had fix. And here's our survey points. Now you see a lot of points there, a lot more points than we took when we were doing this survey. And that's because the Rhinox file contains the position at, you know, every second or 5 seconds. I forget how often it takes measurements. I think it's every second. So every second is a new position estimate. And what we want to do now is we're going to incorporate the CSV file, which we exported from Emlid Flow. Emlid Flow is the app which goes on your phone, and that goes along with the Emlid Reach GNSS receiver. So we're going to take that CSV file, which contains all the points that we measured in Emlid Flow, and we're going to actually upload that here. So I've got my file containing points, and I'm going to go ahead and uncheck float. So I'm only going to keep points in this case where I have a full fix, and fix is the best connection between the rover and the base station. And that's in general the points that you're going to want to use, because those points are going to be the most accurate. I'll go ahead and say start. And now you can see what the Emlid Studio has done is it's eliminated all the extra points, and now we only have the points where we actually took the measurements. You can see those points along here. You can say show result file. That's going to open up a Finder tab or a Windows Explorer tab, and you'll see file 1, group 1 corrected, and that's actually going to be a file containing our longitude, latitude, and elevation points. And these are going to be our corrected positions. So you'll see corrected there. It's going to make a copy of your original CSV file. It's going to put in the corrected positions, and that's the file that you'll want to use. These positions are the positions that you'll want to use to actually plot when we do the plotting exercise in QGIS. So these will be your corrected positions, your RTK or your PPK final positions. And again, if we come back over to Emlid Studio, we can actually go back and we can change this, we can update this, and we can put in the information for the latitude, longitude, and height from the post-process PDF. We would do the same thing. We would hit process and again regenerate our corrected CSV file, and that would give us our final post-process kinematic rover positions from all those points that we measured, in this case along this line here. Okay, so that's how you would post-process GPS points in Emlid Studio using Stop and Go with Emlid Flow. You'll need those Rhinex files, the navigation file, the CSV file with your measured points, and then you can go through this workflow and your final locations will be in that CSV file that gets generated. And you can open the CSV file in Excel, or in this case, I'm in Visual Studio Code to look at that CSV file, pretty much anything. And it will have the description of all the different fields at the top of the file here. Okay, so that should get you going with Emlid Studio, and I will see you in the next video.